Welcome back to our tutorial series. On this episode, we're going to try something a little bit controversial. We're going to edit this picture and then go back and give it an Instagram look. Now, this picture was taken by a man named Jared Polin. He used a Canon T2i and a 17-50 lens. I don't know where he stands on the whole Instagram thing. Some photographers love it, some photographers hate it. I'm not going to cast any stones. I'm just going to edit it both ways, and then you can decide which one you prefer. So, remember what I said before about making sure you use the proper calibration. I do not like Adobe Standard for pretty much anything. For this one, maybe we'll try Camera Landscape, and that already gives it a much better look, in my opinion. Now, we're going to do a quick adjustment to the exposure just to make it look a little bit better, and then start thinking about the point of this picture. The main focus, the subject, is this tree. So what we really want by the end is the tree to look awesome. And it's looking a little bit flat. There's not enough distinct features in it. So what we might do is come in here with the clarity and raise it up quite a bit. In fact, let's also grab the contrast. And we just want that really to pop. We want the brights and the darks and the cracks and the bark to all look pretty awesome. But when we come back out, we've now made this picture look all grimy, which isn't really the look we might want. So let's come in here with the shadows. Raise those up, try to get the darks to be less dark. In fact, let's also grab the blacks, raise that up to just pull down from some of that oppressive griminess. Let's maybe also knock the temperature down just a little bit, and then let's start having some fun with vibrance and saturation. Remember, vibrance takes some of the lower saturated colors and bringing them up. Saturation just grabs all of the colors and makes them all more saturated. So let's maybe do a 40-20 split. And what I'm already kind of drawn to is this area down here being not the same as this area down here. So let's grab a brush. Actually might be okay. Highlights, we want to make the tops of this brighter, like the tops of this. We want the dark areas in here to be more like that. So we will come in here and paint along here. Just kind of bringing the luminance values to be the same. But I think it's maybe a little bit too saturated over there. If we pull this down, it starts looking more like the other side. I think that's probably good enough for a quick edit. All right, so we've got the basic look of the picture down. Maybe what we want to do, though, is add just a little bit of saturation to the sky. So remember, this HSL will allow you to use this little tool to just raise. That's maybe a little much. Something like that. Now the blues look even bluer. Maybe we'll come down here and start working on the sharpness now. Remember, on a PC, you can hold Alt and grab one of these sliders, and it will show you exactly what you're editing. So we want the tree and maybe the grass to just have a little bit more presence. We'll go up to maybe there, and then with detail, same thing. That's probably good there. And then masking, we want it to not be in the sky. We want it to be just on the parts that make the most sense. So maybe something like that. And in fact, I'd probably call that good for our first initial edit. Let's come in here real quick and make a snapshot. Oops. Now we can always come back to this. So let's move on to the Instagram look. Now, let's say you are a Portland musician and you're looking to make some album art for your latest album. What you might want to do is give it that desaturated kind of 1960s lo-fi look. First thing you definitely want to do is kill the vibrance and the saturation. Those older, 1960s film slides didn't have that same pop that a modern camera would give you. In fact, we should kill this as well. But one of the most defining things about that era of film was the way that the tone curves look. They definitely had kind of a washed out, kind of middle of the road look. Actually, let's add a control point somewhere in here, where the highlights weren't as bright and the darks weren't as dark. So let's maybe pull something in there. Yeah, so now it's got that kind of Instagram look going on. Although no Instagram photo would be complete without a vignette of some kind. So let's maybe drop one of these in here, bringing up the feather all the way. And then we need to go back and adjust the exposure to give it a more pleasant look. Oh, wait, the most important part of an Instagram picture, the one-to-one crop. Let's come in here real quick, put one of these on. Ooh, the tree's not perfectly gonna fit. Although if we get clever and do it kind of like that, maybe. Yeah, you can almost fool yourself into thinking that. Actually, let's try something really experimental here. Let's zoom in here. See if I can take the tip of this guy off. Oh, wait, hold on. Undo that. Let's change it to the clone tool instead of the heal tool and see if that gives us a little bit more. In fact, let's do one from the top and maybe one from the bottom. Make it look like the branch is broken. How about that? So now we've got this Instagram look, which we can also go back in here, add a snapshot. So we've got this look, we've got the original look, and then if we hit the backslash key, we can see where we started. So hopefully that was educational to you. Let me know your feedback. Even let me know which one you prefer. And hopefully next week we'll give you another awesome tutorial.